Well, hey there. It's your old pal Keith from wavetables.lol. That's wavetables.lol. And what I wanted to talk about today is the fact that my humongous collection of wavetables that was previously available for synthesizers that could import the common Serum.wave format, wavetable format, is now available for other synths that support the less common, but still in use, .wt, that stands for wavetable, format, that's used in the Surge XT VST synthesizer. It's an open source synth that has a VST version, a clap version, whatever that is, and also a standalone version. And also, that is the format, somewhat surprisingly, that's supported in Bitwig. Bitwig has a built-in synth called Polymer that's kind of cheap and cheerful, but useful, and a nice sounding synth that I guess you can also customize further. And so I just, long story short, those are now available. So the collection is called KRC Mathwaves. It's available at wavetables.lol. It contains 29,000 plus single cycle waveforms, and then those waveforms have been constructed into a huge number of wavetables using various stochastic and mathematical techniques. The waveforms themselves are based on mathematical equations and, you know, other math-like processes. And so I've got a whole bunch of new wavetables to talk about in that collection, but long story short, they're now available as both the .wave version, bundle files that you can import into Korg modwave or modwave native, if you don't feel like importing the wave files yourself, or you can use them in Serum, et cetera, et cetera. Now they're available in Surge XT, Bitwig's, Polymer Synth, which I'm playing here. It's pretty nice sounding. And there you go. Now, it is completely undocumented how to import wavetables into Bitwig, which is kind of what I wanted to talk about here today. You've got, you know, you've got a Polymer device here, that I've installed, and, you know, it's got all these different, oscillators, but one of them is a wavetable oscillator. And when you've got the wavetable oscillator selected, you would typically have, a big old collection. It's not that large, but there's a collection of built-in wavetables, but you might want to expand that with new ones. And now, in the manual, there's actually no information about what format Bitwig expects, or even how to import the wavetables. So it turns out that even though some on the internet have claimed that Bitwig is one of these platforms that can support Serum-style wavetables, it does not import them correctly. And so it turns out that the format that's used, and sorry, I was kind of trying to find the built-in ones. Where are the built-in ones? I guess they're under Essentials. You can see that these wavetables all have sort of have different sizes. So you can see this 12-string one. The size of the frames of the wavetable is actually 1024. It's more common these days for wavetable synths to support 2048 samples, and then or samples per frame, and then, you know, up to typically 128, maybe 256 individual frames. Now this wavetable happens to be 1024 by 97 frames, and then this acoustic guitar one is only 512 samples per frame. And this one's only 256 by 128. So anyway, so it turns out that the reason for this is that, well, Bitwig is trying to be flexible here. And of course, there are more wavetable, you know, types of formats that you could use out there. But to import these different, you know, size frame wavetables, it uses actually the same .wt format that was developed for the Surge XT synth. So what I did is I went through and I converted all of the wavetables that are available in my collection, KRC Mathwaves, to .wt format. And if when you go get them from wavetables.lol, I hope you'll buy the full collection. I might even do like a little coupon code. Look in the description for a link to maybe a special promo deal. It's $29. It gets you a whole lot of fun for that money. But now you can use them in a lot more places. Okay. Talkie. See, I'm talkie. How long have I been going? Let's look and see here. I've already been talking for 6 minutes and you're like, well, get on with it. Well, that's really what I came here to say, is that these things are available. But I did want to show you how to import stuff into Bitwig. So when you've got Polymer open and you click on the wavetable preview, you can now right click, and I recommend right clicking up here, like over here is most reliable. You can right click other places, but it won't always show you this context menu. This is Bitwig 5.1, so it's the latest version as of this recording. And so you right click and there's an import wavetables context menu option that appears. That's great. Then when you click on it, what appears is a little bit strange. This is actually a folder import dialog. It does say up here, select folder to import wavetable files from. But it's easy to miss that. And what this is doing is it allows you to select a folder that contains .wt or .wave, but like I say, it does them wrong. You can select a folder that contains .wt wavetable files, and it'll import all of the wavetables that are in that directory. The other thing it does, actually, again, not documented at all, is you can select like a top level. You could select a top level directory, and I just lost where I was. You can select a top level directory and it will actually import all of the folders underneath it and all of the wave forms that are in there. And it preserves the directory structure over in your library. So just as an example, I think this is a folder I haven't, imported yet. So you click select folder. And now actually, if I were to drill down on this and click select folder, you'll see a weird thing. It doesn't actually show the individual files that are in that directory. But you are selecting a folder and whatever's in there, it will try to import. So we'll click select folder. And then now you'll see the little spinning doohickey goes up here. And if you click it, we see that it's importing wavetable files. Now it just did that. And if I can remember what the hell I just imported. Oh, it's the Random Explore 16. So these are wavetables from the KRC Mathwaves collection that have 16 different waveforms in them. So they're not really designed for sweeping so much, at least not over large areas. They're a little more for dialing in a specific waveform, but. So you can hear that. There's a lot of different waveforms in there. With a wavetable like this, you would typically like disable interpolation and you would like turn off any, whoops, let's just remove that. You typically turn off any modulation and then you just kind of dial, I'm not a big Bitwig hacker, okay? I always forget to like unselect the modulation arrow. But now we could just select a waveform right out of here, right? And of course there won't be any variation over the life of the patch. It'll just be that oscillator. Do, do, do. There's a lot of these bell-like timbres. In my collection. Anyway, that's how you can use these with Polymer. That's a cool waveform. Fat fingers. And, you know, you can sweep these ones if you want to. I guess for those who have maybe never seen my wavetable collections before, I also have, and this is where a lot of the bulk of the library is coming from now, are these wavetables that I created with AI. So I took my collection of sort of an enhanced version of the waveforms that are in KRC Mathwaves and trained a set of variational autoencoders on them. A variational autoencoder is a type of machine learning algorithm, a type of AI that kind of learns to generate new novel things from an example set of data. So in this case, it's trained on these 2048 sample single cycle waveforms, and then it's able to generate new content by sampling different points in the latent space. So I talked about that in my Mad Science AI video that you can find in my channel. But these have really cool sounds. Ooh, let's do some sweeping on this, shall we? Let's do, let's go here. Like, the one weird thing about Polymer is that it doesn't have a dedicated envelope or anything for the wavetable position. I guess that's left as an exercise to the user. Like, you can go into Polymer and, oops, no, don't do that. Oops, okay, I don't want to save a preset, thanks. You can go into Polymer and you can right-click it and you convert it to a poly grid, and then you could, let's look at that. Can we see this grid? There we go. You can convert it into a poly grid, and then you could like duplicate things and stuff. You can add envelopes, you could add filters, you could add new controls and stuff like that. Again, I'm not like super into that. I would be, boy, if I were younger, I'd have been like all over that. Because I was a huge, if I were younger, I mean, if I was younger right now, right, I would super be into this probably, because I was a big Nord Modular hacker. But these days, I'm a little more like, I've got my favorite synths for doing different things. And, you know, I don't want to sit around and make, you know, my own synthesizers anymore. But I do like making my own oscillators, you know, so which is why I made this giant collection of waveforms and wavetables. So go figure, different strokes for different folks. But these have a bunch of cool sounds in them. And again, there's tens of thousands of these. There you go. One other thing I guess I wanted to cover, I'll take a little pause and then do it. You know, the video, if you just came here to like hear this announcement or just, you know, see how to import wavetables into Bitwig, hooray, we're done. But it occurred to me, that in the same way that I needed to take my, like, you know, 120,000 wavetables and convert them from wave format to the .wt format, that other people could probably use the script that I used for that. And so I did put a post over at wavetables.lol. Again, there'll be a link in the description that has a link to a Python script that you can just point at a source directory of Serum-style wavetable files, and then also give it a destination folder. And what it will do is it will walk that entire directory, take all of the wavetable files. They do need to be of the same type. We'll talk about that in a minute. It'll just walk the directory, convert everything, and like put it in a new directory where the directory hierarchy is preserved. And so then you could just very easily, you know, come over here into Bitwig and then just import, you know, the entire folder. And there you go. Bingo, bango, boom. You could turn a whole bunch of other, you know, Serum format wavetables that you found on the interweb or that you either made out of Serum or whatever, and you can convert them into Surge XT/Bitwig/ I don't know what else uses .wt format, but I bet there's a bunch of stuff out there I've never heard of. So anyway, I'll take a little pause and then I'll come back and we'll talk about using a Python script, okay? Well, all right, so let's talk about this script. So there'll be a link in the description to a post where there's a Python file attached. And this is just a script. After you download it, you could open it in some text editor. I'm using VS Code here because I'm that sort of person. But you could use any old text editor like Notepad or, you know, whatever is on the Mac and Quack these days, or in Linux, whatever thingy you use for editing text files. And you open it up and it's pretty simple to use. I'm not going to explain all that it does, but it basically just walks a certain directory, takes all of the wave format wave tables that are in there, converts them to .wt format, and then, you know, saves them to a target directory, right? Preserving the directory structure. So you just open this thing up and then you just set your source directory to, you know, whatever folder you've got your wavetable files in. So come on, get in here. Where'd you go? Okay. Let's see here. Modwave. Let's see. Okay, so I've got this folder here called Test Wavetables Wave Format, right? That it has, let's see, well, there's a wave format wavetable here in the top directory, and there's a couple of subdirectories that have wave format wavetables in them. Okay, cool. Cool, cool. And these are all the standard, you know, the serum type wave format. I'll talk about that in a minute. I don't know if that's interesting to people or not. But anyway, you can just like, you can, you know, take this directory, make that your source directory. And then there's a weird thing in Python under Windows where you have to escape the backslashes. You know, Windows uses a really weird kind of file directory structure. And the backslash is a reserved character in Python. And so you got to put two of them in there. Anyway, so there's my, I'm going to say, okay, my source directory is test wavetables wave format, and then my target directory is going to be in the same folder, and it's going to be called test wavetables WT format, okay? And then I can just run that script. So I'm going to save it, and I'm going to actually just save it in that same directory. I think it's already in that directory. Yep, I'm already there. Okay, so we just save it to that directory, and then we can get our bash shell or whatever. I use git bash. You might have a different shell installed, or you might need to go install one. I don't know, whatever. You know, as with, this is not a generic tutorial on welcome to Python. But if you got Python installed, right, you may not have these libraries installed. So, you know, you would do pip install all of the required things here. So we're going to, you know, we're going to use NumPy, we're going to use OS, and we're going to use soundfile. I guess it's NumPy. Say it right. So we would go, now mine are only installed. But we do pip install numpy. Should work. Oh, I'm not in the right place. Doesn't really matter. Requirement already satisfied. Already has that. Okay, and then we do pip install OS. Okay. And it'll go out. This is magic. This is the magic package installer stuff, right? And then you do pip install sound file. And these are just libraries that this script uses. Python's really cool because it just has all these great like math and science and media manipulation type of libraries that tend to be much better than JavaScript. And then I'm just going to change directories to, where is this directory? What is your name? Your name is this. Come back, bash. There we go. We'll just change directories to, oops, do it right, cross. There we go. Paste. Okay. We'll change there. We'll do ls. Yep, we're there. Like we can do ls star dot py. Oh, there's no, oops. We got to go back up one. Cd backpack. Under modwave. There we go. We're in the right directory now. Star dot py. Okay, so there's, yeah, there's my script. And then we're going to execute it just by saying Python. And then the name of the script, convert dash wave wavetables to wt format dot py. And boom. And it's going to churn for a second. Conversion complete. And then if I go and go back to my modwave directory, oh, look, now I have exactly like I wanted to create test wavetables WT format. And then inside this, oh, look at that. There's a WT file here at the top level. There are WT files under that subfolder. And then this folder has a folder inside it. Oh, that has more wavetables. Hooray. And so now we could import those into SurgeXT or to Bitwig. Cool, 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 right? There you go. Don't say I never gave you anything for free or whatever they say. Is that what they say? I don't know. Anyway, go get KRC Mathwaves. Again, it's $29 usual. I'll put it on special, just a celebration of having these .wt files. Go watch my other videos in my KRC Mathwaves whatever they're called, collection here on YouTube. There'll be a link in the description. And have fun making noise with wavetables. I'll talk to you later. Chowder.